Okay, so let's start with this live demo. So this live demo will be set up with two different areas. One first will be a global explanation about how to print a soft robot gripper. And then we will have a question and answer phase where you could raise the hand and have the opportunity to send some questions. And I will be pleased to answer them. Okay, so let's start with soft robotics. Let me start this one. So soft robotic application. So today we will focus on one application, which is gripper. So silicone printing of gripper. It could be suction cup, but it's gripper. So today what we have is, for example, here, gripper fixed on the robot arm to grab some parts. So during this presentation, we will see, here is an example about how you could grab some strawberries, for example, some soft material to don't be damaged. So during this presentation, we will see how first to design the part, then to slice it, to implement the G-code in the printer, and then finally, how we could get the part printed. So let's start with this part. First of all, I will tell you that today we are going to print with small syringes for 55 milliliter, as you could see here. It's going to be cup seal 40-50, so 40 short A silicone. And there is also option to print with big capacity cartridges, as you could see here. On this slide, we could see that there is option with big capacity cartridge. So still the same process, we are using pressurized air to push the material and then the extrusion. So let's start with the design by itself. So let me see this design. So this is the gripper I showed you just before. So we design it. Key point is when you are designing your silicone part, you need to take into account the silicone design guide, which gives you all the today's limitation of the designing. So for example, here you will see that we designed this part to avoid using the support material. So let's have a look on this one to make a cut. And here you will see that all the design follow the rule of having 45 degree angles to allow to not have support material. Because if we are using support material on this, you will understand that it's quite complicated to remove all the support material through this small hole. So once you get the design of the part, then you will export this design to your computer through STL format. Then we will go to the slicer by itself. So slicing will be the operation to tune all the different parameters for the printing of the part. Through the customer hub platform that we implement with Linkster, you could directly download the profile of the material according to the printer. So if we look at here, we already downloaded it. Here is the profile for the S300X. So on this one, you will have the ability to choose which kind of print you would like to do, from very small nozzle diameter, 0.34, to very large one with 1.04 millimeter. There is usually the choice between speed and look according to your need. So today we will select the nozzle diameter 6.5 millimeter with speed to have a short print. On this one, with the profile that you downloaded, you have already all the parameter tuned. If you want to access to this parameter, of course, you can change everything. For example, here for this specific part, we implement top solid layer and bottom solid layer, but two layers to be sure that there will be no leakage of air with this specific gripper. And then all the other different kind of parameters, of course, temperature and so on. So then we selected this part. We are going to run the slicing of the part. So preparing the G-code. So here is the result of the slicing. As you could see, so the green part is here. This is the solid layer, the external, internal first layers. So of course, this one is quite important to have the airproof of the part. As you could see here, we're going down and we have all the difference. First one, solid one, then you go up to this one, still keeping the 45 degree limitation to avoid support material. Here is the infill. And then as you could see at the end, there will be the bridge between the two walls, which is quite sensitive, that can be done with our technology. Okay, so this is the G-code, it has been done. This is the the slicing. Now we need to export it with getting the G-code. So it's already downloaded with the previous video call that we did, the video live demo that we did. So here is the name that we use. This is a recommendation. When you want to don't miss any information, put the nozzle diameter, the layer height that you choose, the material, and the printing time. So no need to record it, it's already recorded. Now we need to add this file implemented in the printer. So through this, we could go directly through the control. Let me log out to show you directly how it is. All right, log out. So here you could see that this is the IP address that we have for the printer. So it allows you to directly connect through the printer remotely from your computer, from your office, far from the printing area. And you could manage the number of connection available with administrator, with restriction of the access to different parameters. So let me connect. So here we will find exactly the same interface that we could have on the printer by itself with some summary. So here is the last print that we did with successful, fortunately, this morning. In this area, you will have, okay, let me clear the filter. You could have the different kind of folders where you could put your files to organize your prints. So it could be by name, it could be by activity. So let's go on live demo where we have, and here is the gripper that we have. If you don't already download the part, upload the file, you just go to add file, go for search, and then we could find here the live demo. Here is the file that we found today previously. So now we have the file upload. Okay, last one is regarding the settings. So information more about the machine, the different kind of users and so on. So now we already upload the file in the printer. We could launch the print. So let me go to this area. So go back to this printer. So S300X, LIQ21, LIQ11. So two tool head, IDEX technology, Cartesian IDEX technology. One tool head with B component tool head. So B component material, silicone, it could be polyurethane, it could be epoxy. And then mono component tool head, LIQ11. So today we have here a syringe of support material. It could be in different kind of application, conductive ink in case of soft robotic. As I said previously, if it's syringes or cartridges, we are always using pressurized air to push the material up to the entrance of this red area. I'm not sure if you could see that. This is the volumetric microdosing pump from Viscotech, which allow this technology to achieve 0.05 milliliter precision. two inert material will finally arrive in the entrance of the static mixer that you could see here, static mixer. Clean one, of course, it is the only consumable part. Then we could directly print the part. Regarding the interface, so this is here the interface with a step-by-step mode. So we could go selecting the part, and then you have a step-by-step guide to let you know exactly what are the steps to follow before the print. There is option to go through advanced mode to skip all these different operations. But here to show you everything. So static mixer, as you just show on the video that we installed this one, everything has been done prior to this one. Calibration, of course. Calibration X, Y, and Z. Purge, and here is the purge. So we are going to run the purge because this is a new static mixer and we need to have the A and the B mix inside the static mixer. Let's run the purge. So we'll go to the other area where there is a small cup to receive the material. So the purge is starting, and then we could launch the print after that. Let me having the purge doing the okay. This is okay. We have the mix of the two material. So just for your information, the 4050 is in white transparent at the beginning, white transparent. But here for this application, we put some pigment in one of the two components to have a blue. There is option to have purple, yellow, gray. All the colors are available as we could put pigment in one or the other. So now let's start with the print. So let's have a look inside the printer. We already purged it. Okay, but it's gone again. So we purge again and we will have the print of the two parts. So yeah, this is how you could also have the material in the big cartridges of 750 milliliter when syringes is 55. Okay. Then we could go to the first layer. So as we saw previously on the G code, there is the outer skirt, which is the first printing perimeter to be sure that we are at the right height for the print. So I'm checking. Yeah, perfect. We are just on the right height. So no need to adjust with the baby step for adjusting the height of the nozzle. So this is the print which starts. So first outskirt, and after that, we are going to print the internal area of the part. we saw that in the previous simplified 3D that we, the slicer that we use. For this one, it's going to be something like 2 hours of the print for a material about 30 grams. And if we talk about the price of material, it's going to be something like 11 euro just for the material by itself. So we launch the print. We already print the part prior because 2 hours with you will be very nice, but it's going to be better to show you directly the result. So this is the part, as you could see. It's very nice to remove. Having additional tray allow you, of course, to be able to print, wait for the cross-linking time to be finished, and then having the part. So here is the part. The formulation that we use today is 40-50. 40 is a short hardness, 50 is a gel time. So gel time is a time above which one you won't be able to mix the layer together. So after 50 minutes, no way to be able to print another additional layer on what is have been already printed. To get the final functional part, you need to wait about 3 times the gel time. So all in all, 2 hours, something like 2.5 hours for having this. In less than 5 hours, you have the finished silicone gripper. So let's go now on what could be done. Today, we already sold a lot of machines in soft robotic application. It's a demanding and it's a lot of opportunity in this area, of course, because we discover a lot of options that we could do with this technology. If you check the small video here, it's a video done regarding the work that one of our colleagues, Brice, who is PhD in specialized in soft robotic. So he ran some study about what could be done with the printing. So as you could see here, there is two different kind of color, one red, one blue, which is roughly the ratio of A and B that we adjust. So finally, the red one is softer than the blue one. And you could see that finally, you could directly push the inflation in some way or the other. The other work that he did is on the layer height. We could adjust the layer height during the print. And you see that finally, with bigger layer height, you will have softer area. So that said, it's just to tell you that if you want to have more knowledge about soft robotics, you could, of course, ask the Linkster team to support you on this. We have the expertise and we have a lot of case study that we already did. I think that's roughly what we could say about this, showing you this small gripper also. I think we're done for this. And if you have any question, I will be very happy to answer all these questions.